Of course, you know this face, probably one of the most famous in the world. This is Marilyn Monroe, painted by the pop artist Pauline Boty. Pauline Boty at that time was a young artist, but already quite well known. She was born in 1938, and in 1954, she went to the Wimbledon Art College to be trained in art. Her father did not want that. She wanted her to marry and to have kids and to have a normal life of a woman of that time. But she really maintained her commitment to art and went to this art school. But she was sent to a class dedicated to stained glasses because it was considered at that time that painting was a male thing. And she was supported by a teacher who really pushed her and gave her some advice and really encouraged her to continue. He really saw the talent that she already had. Finally, she managed to make her own place and space in this group of pop artists of the time. She was close to Derek Boschier or Peter Blake and many others. And she was quite soon famous and nicknamed the Bardot of Wimbledon. She was also a model, she was an actress, and she had her own radio broadcast on the BBC. And on this radio broadcast, she was sharing a lot about the movements of that period, and especially the movements of emancipation and the beginning of feminism. Regularly on her radio broadcast, she was sharing considerations about the place of the young woman in society, claiming for more rights, more equality, and for the possibility to have their own destiny. She managed to do that through radio, but also through her art. And in 1961, she took part to a very important pop exhibition of that time in Britain. Here she did a portrait of Marilyn Monroe. This painting is from 1962. Its title is Color Her Gown. And it was made the year of the death of Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe was really an icon. She was a pop actress. She was represented by a lot of pop artists such as Warhol, who also represented her lips, considering that the lips were enough to recognize the whole face of Marilyn Monroe. She was also represented by Rotella and many others. Here, this portrait is very different from the traditional pop art aesthetic and from the magazines. We don't see the usual erotic and very glamour representation of Marilyn, very sexy. We are very far from the Hollywood icon. It's a very tender and very delicate portrait. It could be the portrait of a friend. And we can see this unusual Marilyn painted with this background of flowers and squeezed between those two panels of abstract and ornamental fields. It's really like a kind of tribute. We feel here in this painting the disappearance of the star. It was really for Pauline Boty a tribute because she was considering Marilyn Monroe as a model for a whole generation of young women, a model of a woman who was free, who was living in her own personal and sexual life, despite the convention, despite the moral, despite the conservative mood of the time. And she really wanted to push this image of Marilyn. Pauline Boty was famous at that time already. Unfortunately, she died at the age of 28 of leukemia and disappeared for decades before being rediscovered a few years ago and put again at the right place of a huge member of the pop art.